Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Yes.
As we mentioned before, many times the Holy Fathers would study Scripture, the Holy Gospel, and take it word for word and explain it to us so that we could have a clear understanding as to what God is and how we should believe in Him and how we should worship Him and glorify Him. As we see in today's Gospel, when the Samaritan woman, when she was revealed to her that Christ was there as a prophet, at first she thought, and when He revealed to her her sinful life, her first question was about the faith. Because God said that we know the true God. They came from the Jews through the Scripture, through the Old Testament prophecies, and to fulfillment of the coming of the Messiah, to which she spoke and didn't understand that it was the very Messiah that was standing, that was before her. One of my favorite parts of that Gospel is when his disciples came back from buying the meats, by buying the food for them to be able to eat. And they were wondering why Christ was talking to the Samaritan woman, but none of them had enough courage or dared to even ask Him that question. But when Christ said to them that my weight is to do the will that sent me and to finish His work, they couldn't understand who brought Him this food. And when Christ said unto them, say not ye that there are yet 4 months and then there cometh the harvest. Behold, I say unto you, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to harvest. And what is interesting that the Holy Fathers teach us that, as we know, in the Holy Land, in the place of Samaria, it's very, very hot. And of course the people would wear white clothing because this, of course, keeps them cooler. They don't get so hot when they're wearing white. And what was happening at this time, by the time the apostles came back to Christ, the people of the village for which the Samaritan woman already told them, come and see the man who told me all things that I have done, whatsoever I have done. So the people in mass started to come out of the city and go towards Christ on the hill where the well was of Jacob. And so when Christ told them to look upon the fields, because you say that yet there are 4 months before the harvest, and lift up your eyes and look on the fields, and when they looked on the fields, they were covered in white, not because the wheat was already to harvest, because that was the wheat does, it turns white when it's ready for harvest. But they looked and they saw the white, and it was this mass of people dressed in white coming to Christ, coming to get the edification, coming to get spiritual nourishment, coming to understand that this is the Christ, the Savior of the world. So this is the fruit about which Christ speaks. Do the will of His Father, and that is to save all the souls of all the people that wish to come to Christ. And it was interesting that this is what we were taught in seminary, that this is the duty of a pastor, is to save his flock and to see the fields full of white, pure hearts that want to be saved by coming to Christ. And he goes on to teach us about the wages, about gathering fruits into life eternal. Because he said that they that have sown and they that reap both gather fruits. In other words, in all people, when they do their duty unto Christ and following Him and taking up the cross, we all enter into this heavenly kingdom. Because there are people that have toiled before us. There are people that pray for us. There are people that have looked after us. And yet we must do the same and look after people, that we all share the love of Christ. Because as we say so many times, St. John the Evangelist, who wrote this very Gospel, is the one that said that God is love. And if we deal with love truly, if we deal with God truly, then we will have love in our hearts, and this love will spread, and we will be able to harvest the fields, be able to harvest.